Hello everyone. So let's take a look at the next advent of code, day 12. So it's gonna be there in like 15 seconds. I found out I didn't have to start doing part 2 from scratch. I could have reused part 1 of day 11, but didn't think of it. So, day 12, come on. So, digital plumber. Pipes. Cat, come on. How many programs are in the group that contains program ID 10? Okay, so hello. We need to find out like transitive. I don't set membership or something. I'm not sure. Is spanning tree what it is? Nope. But so let's see. We have elm graph somewhere. Graph. Can we do something about it? Induced subgraph. I'm not sure what it is. So I'm not sure right now. Oh, right. This could be it, maybe. We'll see. Could we do something by hand? Like we could recursively check, but then there can be cycles. We can do something about it. Okay, let's just start getting the input into some kind of data for us, and we'll see what to do. Here. Day 12. So the input is list of this could be a nice structure to work with. So import dict import set. The output is how many programs contain program ID 10, so 0. So integer, let's put an input here. Okay, some tests, so there's only one. I can do this, copy this again. Give me just a second, the cat is being weird today. All right, I'm back. So this didn't work much. Let's try again. This is better. So the parse input is from list, and 3, 4, 5, 6. 1 is 1, 0, 0, 3, 4, 2, 4, 2, 3, 6. 6, 4, 5. The output is six. So the compute, let's give it some bogus value. So how can we parse it? Input string lines, list map, parse line. We didn't have a list. List from list. So parse line. Int set int. So. So let's this, and we can actually do, oops, can actually do it right here. Left, right, otherwise crash. So string string split by command space, list map, to integer and set from list. So I think this should work. So let's see. Line. Yeah, grade 12. Day 12. I just said grade 12. Hello, Graysell, and it's day 12. it's the morning. Expected 6, actual. Okay, so it seems we parsed it. We parsed it correctly. So now. So I think we can just imagine we have a nice function that will tell us if that key somehow has the value, and then we just have to build it. So key value. Neighbors. So neighbors. Is it member? It is. So this will give me a wrong answer because it doesn't look transitively. Dictionary size. Actual one. So right, because there's only two. Neighbors or n equals 0. Right. So an input. I think we can do is neighbor with integer input boolean. So if n equals 0, we are done. Else false, we can then fix this we'll be able to make it into just one big conditional, but this is for clarity. So that will be just with default. So input is input. And now the recursive thing. So so list any could help me. Yeah, right, but we have a set. So let's do set to list. Hello Eric, good morning to you too. Well, you probably have midnight, right? Okay, so let's put it a bit. Okay. So I wonder if this will be horribly recursive. We'll see. Is neighbor with number input was wrong. Dict filter. What? Zero. What? It needs one more input. Yeah, right. No. Maximum call success exceeded. Great. So, so we'll have to give it visited nodes. So visited will be empty here, and in the recursive thing, it will be set what insert, set insert num. Yeah. So still, yeah, because we didn't, we just wrote to it, but we didn't read it anyway. So if list filter and visited set member and not. So we don't want to check visited numbers. Test passed. Okay, oh, it already ran. I wanted to copy the number, the input, and forgot. We already did it. So okay, day one is done. Group, all right. Part of the same group. There were two groups. How many groups are there in total? So either we can try to use the graph thing, because there were some. There was something I think we could have used, but I'm not sure where it is now. Yeah, let's just do it ourselves. So, what can we do? First, let's do the tests. So there are two groups. Our test should fail, and now what to do? We can for each number. We can create a list of all neighbors. It'll be horribly inefficient, I think, but it could work. So let me just refactor, or just make this into something different. So, compute, so input dict map, values don't know, could it work? It could. So all neighbors, we take number. Input number, and we give back set of neighbors. So yeah, this will be horribly inefficient. I wonder if it will like finish at all. So input, because we Travels once and twice. So maybe let's do it differently. Let's do find groups, input. List. Find groups, input, set. What do you want to do? Let's keep it simple. List of integers. Can that's the group, right? That's the group. So we have integer. Set of integers, lists, yeah, right, groups, and return groups. So input, no, number, neighbors. Groups, so okay, we already have the neighbors, so we have to list filter group which contains the number. I don't know, group which contains the number or the neighbors. Let's say the number. How to do it? List map. So if so with this we check if it shouldn't, if we should put it there, like the first element in a group, or if we should find a group and update it. Okay, and 3 will have problems because it can be connected to itself. So if it is there at all. So set from set from list and yeah. So groups, list map, then else. So if let's just format it. Nope, some error. This, yeah, sure. So, if it's there, then set what union oops. So set from list. Tourist. So compute the size, I guess. And yeah, sorry, it's a list. List length. So it didn't catch those. So maybe we have to check is there NG. So probably hello, Cyclone. So I think I'm almost done with part two. I have to find out how to, you know, not create separate list for 4, 5, 6, and have it be merged with this one. So just bug finding. Let's see. Can I So, right. So 5, 6 didn't get there because we didn't check if a neighbor was already there. So. Is there? Yeah, sure. I'm missing the group. Gristle, yeah, it does. And we also have the other way. No, if you want to pipe it somewhere in the middle, you have to do like lambda. So x, my function ax b. So we do not have like threading macro in Clojure where you can use the underscore to signify. Neighbors, are there neighbors? Set to list. Okay, tests passed. Now we are doing. Where does it end? Oh, yeah, right. 2000. So I guess the printing is slowing it down. Oh well. 552, let's see. That's not the right answer. So, I don't know, do I have, right, I do have all the input, all the output. So, so 340 234, right? 236, 6 got added there. Neighbors 5, neighbors 6. So 5 got there. And now, let's see, what's the problem? 082. Okay, I'm not sure how to go about fixing this. I am inclined to just put it into GraphBase. So if I just quickly do, I may be able to see what's the problem, and maybe not. Oops. So syntax error. So okay. So what's wrong? Five five two. So we do not know if it's any, like, if it's big or small. Does it work? Yeah, sure, I didn't do. See. That's huge. Okay, so I might not be able to read anything from that. So what can we do? Let's try to do some tests. Zero, 1 is to 1, 2 is to 2, 3 is to 3. So it should be 0 0 1 1. Three. What? Right. Four groups. Sure. This new line. So, oops. This test passed. There is still some kind of printing. So, what? What could be an edge case? How many groups are there in total? So let's do 0 does 1, 1 does 0, 2 does 3, 3 does 2. So there should be 2 groups. That's okay. There should be just one group with this. Oh, what can we do? What part of the same group? Total number of groups. So, okay, let's see. So, if groups list group almost right. So, filter any group from this group, groups, So set intersect list empty, actually should be empty. So it's invalid, okay. Papa invalid groups. Else wow. Okay. So let's see. So, how can I find 577? So, okay, let's find something about 577. So debug if five seven seven was it? Yeah, 577. Is there a neighbor? Groups list any. Is there an Let's see. Okay, we did a bit too much. Oops. G. Stop it. So, okay, 577. And now is there an G? So it's not there, and it seems, you know, the neighbors aren't there yet either. But when we got to this number, it already was in 0. Now it should be in the 394. So, okay, let's back up. Are there neighbors? So, any of the neighbor is it in this group? Okay, I think I will just print 577 577. Oh man. So, I wonder if I can do it somehow easier. Four. So. Right. So we got this group, but then there's the 394. And why does not 394 see or show us or zero for that matter? So if n is 0, its neighbors are 82. Okay. What do we see at 82? 0, 4, 8, 4, 8, 1, 2, 30. Okay, and neighbors of 0, they didn't get into here. So, okay, what? Something is wrong about this adding. If it's not there at all, then that means no neighbors are in there. If we couldn't find a number, that's in the list. Yeah, so maybe there should be something about the neighbors. Okay, so is there NG or so so this is probably what's wrong. Oh, 73. Let's see. That's not the right answer. This is too high. So let's see the validation again. point in the validation. Okay, come on. So set from list this and come on, I don't see. I can't see. Ah, you have to move. So 82 did not get there. And there's 577 again. So this is not right. So I think, what can we do? If it's there, or the neighbors are there, let's put it there. Okay, let's try to write it recursively. So what was it? And neighbors groups. So if done to do. Case to do. If it's done, then done. No, if it's empty, then we didn't find the number or the neighbors. So, set insert set insert n is gonna be the new group, which is gonna get added to done. So now the group, if the group contains something, so if G is a member, or any of the neighbors are members, So let's see, we can do it like this. Like this, and if group set intersect 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 with n with neighbors. If it's empty, then add to group helper and neighbors. Group done and rest. And else so what's wrong now? 173. Right. So groups here. To group, right, so if there's no intersection, then we keep it. Else we add to it. Yeah, right, and we didn't use this function anywhere. Test one failed on compute. After ending 1 and 3, this is wrong. So 01, okay, after adding zero and one. One and three, group is 01, intersection is 1. Okay. So we if we do union, zero and three, all right. So why I should not have added all right, yeah, we should have like short circuited so let's do this differently. Else, this and so we are short circuiting, I hope. 01 intersect is 1 after adding 03 oh come on. If so, and with neighbors, so found 0 0 1 nowhere. Okay. 1 3. Found it there. Found it there. Oh right. Rest. I am such an idiot. Okay. Okay, and let's print a little bit less stuff. Let's try again. I think I already had 473, right? So let's validate just in case. Oh man. So 308 is being put into two different groups. So what happens? Let's just try a subset. So 496 1051, or I don't know, this one. So there's even six in two places. And the group is empty. So, I don't know, let's validate after every turn. Put it after every turn. So this might blow my stack, I'd say. Okay, so It's getting way slower. In the meantime, okay, we got there. So what 1556 is wrong? 1556. It's already in 60. So if I try to do 89 and 60, I could get it to work. Like, get it to show me the error. So there should be one group, right? And there is. What? Oh man. What about 11? 11 has 98, so it should already get into 11. So we got it to crash in the tests. Amazing. So let's just try to prune it. One, two, two. Remove 895. One 303. Three 15. Alright, so this is the most we can prune it, and the problem is we have eleven 89, we have 60 1456, And then we are trying to put it here. So, what should we do? We have to find a way to merge some of the some of the sets. So it's amazing I at least found a bug. So so the problem happens, I think, only in this case. Merge. So, bad ones are let's see, list conquered map set from list, set to list. So these are all numbers. Bad numbers are all numbers filter one first. Yeah, sure. So hello P Georgiev. Vim theme, actually I don't wait, I should know the Vim theme. I don't know the terminal color scheme because it's from the, what is it, Pantone terminal? Yeah, for elementary OS. And so it's probably solarized. It seems like it. In Vim. I don't even have anything there. I thought I'm using Solarize, but this is probably something default. I don't know. The terminal probably sets the colors such that the default numbers, default colors work. I'm not sure. So contains. So thank you. with numbers. So it is a set. So LM89. If it's empty, then groups. Else to do, let's just test it. To do, right. So, so I have to find why is 11 already somewhere? All right, because 89 also has it. Okay. So that's numbers fold merge number to in the groups yeah that could work I hope so so number groups and we return groups so let's see we can we have to find the groups that it is in and merge them together and let the rest of them be. So, bad groups are groups where where a group contains a bad number. So groups without bad groups is groups. Okay, so we can maybe partition it. Bad groups so is even so the stuff that contains right contains contains integer set of integers boolean okay right so that's good And now, marriage bed groups is bed groups set union set empty, and so we can have merge groups. Okay, let's remove the block and wait for the result. I could have maybe just printed out the end to see how far we are. Okay. Yeah, and I maybe didn't have to validate. Never mind. On so it tries very hard. It's nice to see. Two thousand numbers. It's weird. You know that this should be like pretty easy task. I am probably like overthinking it somewhere. I'm not sure where it is. Connected components. Yeah, that's it. Great. So I didn't print the, like, which number it's currently at, so I don't know. 171, let's see. 171, we'll let this run, but it shouldn't change a thing. That's the right answer. Okay, so I did very I guess very inefficient way to find connected components. Gracel, yeah, it's graph program, definitely. Like, if you know a library, then you use it. Yeah, so pretty bad, like 1 hour and 45 minutes. At least the first part was easier. So, connected components. Algorithms. Breadth first, the first. Loop through it vertices. Start. Yeah. It's undirected. Yeah, so this would have helped me, yeah. Sure, so let's just see again if there's like library. Strongly connected components. Right. So, this would be easier to use, I think. Right, so we are done. It took us, but what can we do? Like, the hard thing about this was finding the edge case, finding this test. And after that, it was not easy to fix, but at least I knew what to fix. So let's commit it. And thank you everybody for watching, and let's see you tomorrow.